Thank you for coming. In this talk, I will talking about the main tools that we have in Docker ecosystem for testing the Docker security, our Docker image, or and the Docker host. Well, my main I am developing with Python, with interesting with tools relating with mature learning in Python, like scikit-learn and PySpark. I am developer in Python and Java, and in the last years I'm interested in tools for security auditing, OSINT, security auditing in Node.js, in Python, and so on. This is the main talk, the main points I'm going to talk. I will make a little introduction to Docker security, what are the security best practices we have, and I'm going to comment the main tools for auditing our Docker host, that is the machine where we are executing Docker containers and Docker image. And finally, a demo for showing these tools in a video. Well, when we are introducing containers, containers basically, if we compare with virtualization, in virtualization we have the classical hypervisor, and in containers what we do is eliminate this layer, this hypervisor layer, and we add the Docker engine. The Docker engine is where containers and image are executing in a isolated way. This is the main container pipeline. This is where we are working with Docker. It's important this view because it provides how is function this Docker at low level. Basically, we have in our Docker host or Docker machine, we have the Docker daemon. The Docker daemon is the main process that is running containers, images, and so on. The image are in a public or private repository. That is in the Docker Hub. In the Docker Hub, we have a classical image like from operating system, web servers. We don't load this image in our Docker host, and the containers execute, and each container, and we are executing this image. What we do is execute a container with the application that we need to that we have to run. And in the other side, we have the Docker client. The Docker client basically are the commands that we provide Docker for build, pull, and run the image that are running in containers. Docker provides, by default, provides several mechanisms, security mechanisms. Some of these security mechanisms we have shown in other tools, like Linux kernel namespaces, cgroups. In this talk, I'm going to comment other security mechanisms that provide Docker, like Linux capabilities, and other mechanisms like AppArmor, CLinux, or Seccom. This mechanism provide Docker for limiting the attack surface in our containers. Where namespaces, basically, as we have seen in other tools, basically provides an isolated view of the system where processes cannot see other processes in other containers. Also, each container gets in its own network stack, and in a default way doesn't get privileged access to the sockets or interface of another containers. And cgroups is another feature that limits and isolates the resource of the resource usage, that is the CPU, memory, networks, and so on. And the other feature that we will see is Linux capabilities. Linux capabilities what provides is divides the privilege of root of the root user into distinct units and a smaller group of privilege. That we will see this feature with examples. When we are working with Docker, we have what is called Docker image. A Docker image basically is a rotatable container, and in each image we have layers. We have the base image, and for each command application that we add to the image, it creates a layer. Basically, all layers are created in read-only mode, except the last that is created in a read-write mode for executing all the operations that the container need to do. Well, basically, we started with a Docker file. The Docker file provides all the commands that are available in the image, and with this Docker file, executing the Docker build command, we construct or build an image. This is a classical Docker file. Basically, we provide the front keyword, that is provides the base image. In this case, we are extending from the Debian image, and in this file, we edit the commands that we need, for example, for installing or executing a web server. In this case, we are installing the Nginx server. We provide the commands for installing the server, for configure the server, and in the last two lines we need to put the commands for executing this image and the ports that expose that image. Sometimes if we are searching in Docker Hub, sometimes we are interested in a specific image. We see that we are analyzing an image, but sometimes we don't have the Docker file. And the question is possible to extract the Docker file from an image? Yes, with that image that is available in Docker Hub, we can extract the metadata of the image in a easy way. Basically, it's a script in Ruby that provides this functionality. What this does is extract the metadata and try to reconstruct the Docker file from the image. Another tool that we have in Docker by default is the Docker history command. With this command, we can see all the commands that we have that are executing in our image. In this case, we are analyzing the Python, the official Python image for view all commands that are executing. We have another tools. For example, MicroBadger is a service that provides this functionality. Basically, you search an image by name and provides all information that is available in the image. Extract all the metadata and shows the commands that are executing. Well, where we are developing with Docker, it's important when we are pulling an image from the Docker Hub from a public or private repository, it's important to to be aware with the content Docker content trust. Docker content trust is, Docker content trust is a new functionality that provides that where you pull an image from a private or public repository, what is that? Is verify that this image is okay, not contains, is an image that is certified by the developer or by the company, and is in a trust way you can trust in that image that is that not contains malicious behavior and these kind of things. Basically, with the command, we can verify the integrity of the image. And for when we are pulling an image, we have two ways for pulling that image. In the first way, we can pull it by DES. The DES is the hash of the image. If we know that the hash of the image, we can pull by this in this way. With the SAA 256 hash, we can pull in this image from Docker Hub. For example, for using this feature, we have the Docker content trust environment variable, and if we initialize it with one, we can pull an image in verifying the DES and the tag that provides Docker in the Docker Hub. But what happens if we are pulling an image that is not in the Docker registry, that is not signed by the developer or the company? What happens is that when we pull that image, we receive an error indicating that this image is not in the Docker registry, and it returns an error. Remote trust data doesn't exist for the image that we are pulling, and in this way we can verify that the image that we are downloading is not is verified by the developer and signed. Well, developer when regarding Docker capabilities, basically a capability is a Unix action a user can perform, and the goal is restrict capabilities where we are running an image in a container. For example, for view the capabilities of a image, we have the cap sh command, and in this way we can see the default capabilities that are available when we are running an image in a container. If we want, for example, restrict the pin command, for example, we can use the cap drop. The cap drop eliminates a specific capability over an image. For example, if we try to run the Python image with the cap drop net row, we are restricting, eliminating the possibility of make a pin in this image. In this screen capture, we can see that if we make a pin over internet service, it returns that pin is lacking privilege for raw socket, and in this way we can, in easy way we can limiting the functionality of a specific container. Another thing that we can do, for example, with the capdraw chown, we can restrict the changing the ownership of a file or directory. In this way, for example, the best practice at this point is that when we are running animas over a container, the best practice at this point is drop all capabilities and only add the capabilities, the functionality that are required in our image. At this point, Docker security basically is about limiting and controlling the data surface on the kernel. And for testing this this feature, basically what we want to do is run file system as read only, so that attackers cannot overwrite data or save malicious script to the image. And in this way, we can assuring that an attacker cannot escalate privilege over the image and so on. Basically, this is what is called the least privilege principle. Basically, what we can to do is not run processes in a container as root for avoid root access from attackers. At this point, the best practice is enable user namespace where we are creating a Docker file or executing an image. It's important assuring that we are enable user namespaces or creating a specific user in the Docker file for avoid the execution as root. And the other feature is code down the kernel calls that a container can make to reduce the potential attack surface. In this case, we can use tools like Abarmos, Linux, or Seccomp. That's an example. Well, with the Dockerfile security point of view, basically this is the minimal configuration that we can do for setting a specific user and not using the default root, because if you don't define a user by default, all applications run as root in containers, and this is the minimal that we can do for specific a user. Created a group or a user for this. And for read-only containers and volumes, we have the read-only flag, and in this way we can limit the create files or directory, and limiting this feature. This is the minimal thing that we can do for avoiding attackers to get over privilege in the image. Well, for example, for restrict the system calls, we have the seccomp. The seccomp is an interesting tool like Abarmos or Linux that allows limiting the kernel manipulation, executing mount opt in the owner and groups. For example, if we want to limit the commands that are executed in a image, we have the seccomp tool. What we have to do is define a JSON, what we can call policy JSON, and in this JSON we define the commands that we want to block in the container. For example, in this case we are blocking the syscalls for creating directory, for change permissions, change ownership, and in an easy way we can pass as parameter this JSON when we run an image, and we can see that when we run this image, we can see that when we execute create directory or change permissions, it shows information related that we can create directory operation for changing permissions no permit and so on. And in a easy way we can limit the syscalls and the kernel calls. Well, now I'm commenting the tools that we have in Docker ecosystem for auditing the Docker host, the Docker machine. That is the Docker machine when we are executing containers and image. The first one is the Docker-based security. This is the main tool that we have for auditing Docker environments and containers. It's an open source tool. It's available in GitHub repository and runs against containers current running on Synchos. And basically what this do is check the best practice that provides a Docker benchmark document. We can execute this tool in three ways. We can use Docker Compose. We can use a specific image that is available in Docker Hub. We can clone the repository and execute Docker build. Basically, these are the main points that is checking this tool. It checks the host configuration, the Docker daemon configuration, the container image and build files, container runtimes, and other operations related with Docker security. The other tool that we have for testing, for checking the Docker host security is lynis. Lynis is available also in GitHub, and basically it's a Linux security auditing and system hardening tool that includes a module, a specific option for auditing Docker files. Well, now I'm showing a video for showing these tools. This is the execution of the Docker-based security. Basically, I am running, I have an image running in a container. With a Python image, and Docker-based security, what is that? Is for each image running in the container, it checks memory, CPU, if the container is running with root user, and a lot of checks in the Docker host. We have seen the warnings that provides this tool, and if we now launch the same image but with a specific tags like read only, limit memory, no privilege, limiting CPU, and so on, if we try to execute the same tool over that image, we can see that the warnings that we have seen before it now show. This is because we are limiting the memory, the CPU, we are executing the container with a specific user, and we can see that the warnings disappear. it show all the warnings related with a health check, but the health check is another flag that we can use for this. And the other tool that we have is Lynis. This is the security of Lynis. We have two options: auditing the system, the complete system. It shows our reports that provides all information that are related with the kernel, memory and processes, user groups and authentication. File system, storage, name services, networking, it using for example IP tables. And they are specific for containers that we can see the Docker daemon if it's running and the containers, the total containers, and what are running, the file permissions if it's okay in that containers, and also checks the presence of AppArmor or CLinux in our Docker host. And well, a lot of check-ins related with the kernel hardening, more advanced users, and it showed a report for that show what a suggestion for go better in our system. Well, this is the main tool that we have for testing the Docker host and for testing, for auditing the Docker image. I'm commenting, basically these tools, what provide is scan your image from no vulnerabilities. Basically, what are these tools? It find non-vulnerability binaries in the components, in dependencies, and so on. I'm commenting these tools, the Docker security scanning. The Docker security scanning is the main tool that provides Docker Hub for analyzing and scanning the where we are pulling when we push an image in a Docker Hub or Docker Cloud. It's analyzing that image over a CVE database. The CVE database is the common vulnerability and exposure database. It's a database where we can find all the vulnerabilities detected in web servers, operating systems, and so on. The Docker security scanning, for example, provides if the image has vulnerable components. It show information related with these vulnerable components and what are the libraries that are vulnerable in that image. It show disability, critical, major, and so on, and it shows the CVE number that we can from this screen we can link to this to this database. OWASP dependency checker, for example, if we are developing our image in Node.js, Python, or Java, it detects vulnerabilities in specific libraries or components that are available in the CVE database. Another interesting tool, for example, Anchor. Anchor it has two options, but the open source solution, it provides an Anchor CLI is a component, basically it's a container image scanner that is available in Docker Hub, and with this tool we can check, analyze the image of that we are running in our Docker host. In an easy way, it detects common vulnerabilities that we have in our image. It shows severity, the vulnerable package, if there is a fix for this vulnerability. It provides a lot of information, but for the image that are executing in our Docker host. It provides also what is called Anchor Cloud. Anchor Cloud provides a way in a visual way we can see policies, vulnerabilities over a specific image. And the last tool I comment is Tenable. Tenable provides, well, this is a commercial tool, but provide a tool called Tenable Container Security that it has a free trial, 2 months, for testing the Docker image that we are. That we have in our Docker repository. What we need to do is fix register in the site and obtain the access key and the secret key for pulling our image over this service. And in an easy way, we can see the results by container image. It shows a report where we can see the information related with most critical vulnerabilities that we have in our image, and it shows the severity, the high severity vulnerabilities or malicious code discovered. If we are interested in more advanced topic for Docker, we have, for example, this project is called Remnux. Remnux is a project that provides that has a lot of images that are available in Docker Hub for malware analysis. If you are interested in this topic, this is a good starting point for checking these tools. And finally, the reference. And the main books that we have in this topic are these, and that's all. Thank you.
Thank you, Jose. So we have a bit of time for questions. Do you have? Yes. You have.
Hi. So. You mentioned that you can choose capabilities to either drop or allow when you run containers. Mm-hmm. But that's you made an example with Docker Run. But if you are using like Docker Server or Docker Swarm, who gets to make the call on which are the capabilities to drop or to have on the nodes?
With Docker Show, how we can drop our capabilities with Docker Show?
Yeah, I mean, I suppose that you can choose the capabilities even with Docker Swarm, but the question is, who chooses which capabilities to drop or to allow, if you know it?
This is who chooses the capabilities for dropping or the. Depending what the project the project type, sometimes will be the the administration, the system administrator, or sometimes the developer.
No, I'm talking about which software handles it. Is it handled on the deploying side or on the receiving side?
When you are developing an image, you can restrict these capabilities.
Mm, okay, thank you.
Thank you. Any other question? Okay, so thank you, Josè.
Thank you.